1600 kilometer at higher altitude from Earth's surface. Now, outer part of exosphere you are calling as magnetosphere. But very little known about this, certain radiation belts are also. So like that, different parts of atmosphere, especially altitude wise, different parts we are going to discuss here. Now certain other data which is relative with this. Say for example, you are aware of Northern Lights. If you have heard about Northern Lights, that from especially higher latitude, we are having this type of light observed in sky. During night time especially, one can observe. That is called as Aurora Borealis. Suppose you are able to observe this type of light in southern hemisphere, then it is called as Aurora Australis. So usually these lights are observed in sky, different colors from violet to green, different colors one can observe. This is probably because a charge, say when sun is giving certain flares, charged particles are thrown away from sun surface. Part of that is able to enter in Earth's atmosphere. But Earth is also having magnetic field around it. And so, any charged particle is in motion, that is producing magnetic field around it. So they automatically get attracted towards North Pole and South Pole of Earth. And therefore, they get entered in the atmosphere. And probably, in kilometer wise, 100 kilometer height, that means, in particular to ionosphere and mesosphere region, they get discharged. They are charged particle, they are coming with very high velocity, and while entering they give their energy to the gases present over here, and then light is produced. The excess of energy that is converted in form of light, and that's why we are getting this type of light, particularly from till 20 degree of magnetic pole. So if you are usually in range of Arctic Circle, say Russia, Norway, Canada, like that countries, and Antarctic Circle near, then you can able to observe this type of light, that is called as Aurora Borealis in Northern Hemisphere, whereas Aurora Australis in Southern Hemisphere. So particular this region where 100 kilometer height is there, this region is important. The lights are produced at that height and observed brightly from Earth. Obviously, I have not visited that area, but on YouTube, certain videos of this Aurora Borealis and Aurora Australis are there. You can just check out, you can get feel that what is the exact idea of these northern lights. I have to concentrate on insolation and heat budget. The first thing, what is insolation? So actually sun is radiating energy all over the surface of sun, but out of that, say for example this is sun, whereas energy is radiation in all possible direction here because this is spherical in shape, whereas this is the size of Earth suppose. So only this much portion, if one can say, or rather in this way we can say from other parts. So only this much energy is able to receive on Earth's surface. So that is total, whatever the energy given out by sun, out of that 2000 million, you are aware of million, million means what, I do into 10 to the power of 6. So only that much part of energy we are able to receive. So keep in mind, whatever energy is radiated by sun, out of that we are able to receive only this much energy. But whatever the total energy received on Earth, that we are calling as insolation. So from all these part of sun, whatever the radiations are coming to the Earth surface, that we are calling as insolation. Now, the thing is that atmosphere is not able to absorb short waves. So first we have to discuss what is long wave and short wave. For that purpose, there is one simple thing. You have to go to our physics lectures, the beginning lectures, where we discuss about spectra. If you are aware of that, all right. Otherwise, just in short, I am giving you here. So try to recollect. Gamma rays are having shortest wavelength. After gamma, there is number of X. Then we are calling as vacuum ultraviolet. Then we are calling as ultraviolet. Then violet. So from violet to red. This range we are calling as visible range. After red, there is infrared, far infrared, then microwaves and radio waves. Usually, here, with this reference, we are calling these waves as long wave radiations and these waves as short wave radiation. So, sun is giving out almost all spectrum. Whereas, we are not able to receive all this in atmosphere. Atmosphere is not able to absorb all. So for example, you are aware that stratosphere is there. That is having ozone layers. So that is absorbing part of UV, not 100%, but part of UV is absorbed by that. So like that, different radiations are absorbed. Whereas gamma rays are having just range of 10 to 12 centimeter in atmosphere. So they get absorbed in upper parts of atmosphere. But remaining these short waves, they are not absorbed directly in atmosphere. Say gamma rays, X-rays, they are absorbed. But ultraviolet, not all. And visible range, not at all. They are just passed out till surface because they are, one can say, the atmosphere is not opaque for them. And therefore, these radiations are coming to the Earth surface. Now, when these radiations are coming out to Earth surface is absorbing them as well as reflecting them. Two things are carried out simultaneously. For example, the color of surface is very important here. One can say, suppose black soil is there, as we are calling of regur type of soil, that is having black color. So black color that indicate almost all radiations are absorbed. Whereas if you are talking of Himalayan part, particularly with India or ice caps present on North Pole and South Pole, then the radiations are reflected back because as that land is covered by ice and especially North Pole there is no land, there is only ice. So that is absorbed, that is reflecting out almost all radiations. I'm not telling you that that's why these regions are cold. Actually, the regions are cold, therefore there is ice. But because of this snowfall or ice cap, the radiations are reflected to greater extent. Whereas, that's why heating decreases because of this radiation. Land is absorbing. Say, whatever the percentage of, depend on color of land, the percentage of light is absorbed by land. Because of this absorption of radiation, land get heated and that hot land now emit radiation, that is in form of this type of radiation we are calling this as long wave radiation. So keep in mind, any hot body definition is temperature should be greater than -273 degrees Celsius. If temperature of body is greater than -273 degrees Celsius, then we are calling that body as hot body. Try to recollect our space lectures, there we have discussed this type of substances. They are able to emit radiations, that is in range of IR, infrared. Usually we are calling thermal imaging. For thermal imaging also we are using this same radiation as infrared radiations. So this is the radiations emitted by this body. So -273 degrees Celsius. If temperature is greater than -273 degrees Celsius, then we are calling that as hot substance. So ice is comparatively very, very hot because ice is having temperature maximum in the range of 0 degrees Celsius. Now keep in mind that whenever this type of temperature, we are having temperature greater than -273 degrees Celsius, then that is capable of emitting this type of radiation. They are called as long radiation. So same way, land is also emitting this radiation and atmosphere, particularly carbon dioxide, water vapor, methane, and other certain gases are there, they are able to absorb this long wave radiation. The result of this absorption of long wave radiation is that the substance, the atmosphere gets heated. So keep in mind that there is warm weather or climate, or there is rising temperature of atmosphere, that is not because they are directly absorbing radiation. Instead of that, say this is land, this is layer of atmosphere, radiations are coming out like that. So because of radiation, this type of incoming radiation that we are calling as insolation. So because of insolation, the land is not going to become hot. But when this is absorbed by land and then reflected back in long wave, then that is absorbed in atmosphere, the gases responsible mainly, their water vapors, carbon dioxide and other gases like methane, etc. Keep in mind, many people are threatening because of greenhouse effect, and they are naming these gases as greenhouse gases. So one can reduce out pollution of carbon dioxide. This is very, very important fact, that one should reduce the pollution of carbon dioxide, that we can say yes, right. But how we can control our water vapors? At so many part of earth is covered by water bodies, we are calling this as hydrosphere. We are not having any control over this hydrosphere. And further, about the carbon dioxide emission, as a rise in carbon dioxide level is there, as well as we are having mechanism that decrease in carbon dioxide level is also possible. The water is best source that absorbs carbon dioxide. Water absorbs carbon dioxide and converted into carbonic acid, H2CO3 is formed. In sea, many part of that absorbed CO2 are precipitated, usually in form of say calcium carbonate. Like that, precipitation is also possible. So large amount of carbon dioxide is absorbed in seawater. So for global warming, it is not necessary that only greenhouse effect or like that carbon dioxide increasing proportion is required. Otherwise, certain questions are unanswerable here. Like we are having ice ages on Earth. Between two ice ages, there is certainly rising temperature. And for long ice ages, there was no evidence of human. And that's why we should not say that only man is responsible or this type of pollutants are responsible. For more detail, we can check out certain data, the rise in amount of carbon dioxide and rising temperature. From 1946 to almost 1975, the rise in carbon dioxide level was very high. But in this particular period, the temperature was decreasing. Can you call this as global cooling instead of warming? So not only we are responsible, as we are saying, that we don't have any control over this universe. We are having just control over certain parts of Earth, not 100% on Earth. And therefore, this type of discussion is actually not that much useful anyway. So this way, radiated gases, radiated heat is absorbed by this type of gases. Now, we have to talk of this thing. Say, whatever the insolation, insolation means light coming from sun, that is called as insolation. So whatever the insolation is there, how it is reflected back in the space. Let us check out the first thing. Whatever gases are present over there, they are reflecting out the instantaneous radiation. So 35% heat or 35% radiations are reflected back. Why 35% radiations are reflected back? Because of atmosphere. The second thing, you are aware that there is stratosphere, which is consisting of ozone layer. Ozone layer is meant to absorb certain UV. Keep in mind, all UVs are not absorbed by that ozone layer or that is called as ozonosphere. But harmful ultraviolet radiations are absorbed by ozonosphere. So because of that, there is rising temperature of atmosphere. That's why you will find that in case of stratosphere, temperature rises from almost minus 60 to 0 degree Celsius. The rise is of 60 degree Celsius. Now next part, that radiations are reaching towards Earth. Say 14% radiations are absorbed in atmosphere. So in short, one can say that 35% radiation get reflected back by atmosphere. Out of total insulation, 14% is absorbed by atmosphere. So just make up total, you will get 49. So now 49% are absorbed in atmosphere, whereas remaining amount, that is 51%, that 51% is reach out till Earth surface. Now Earth surface absorb all 51% and reflected back all 51%, not directly, in form of long waves or short waves also. So whatever reflected back, out of that 17% is escaping to space, as 17% are unabsorbed by atmosphere, they are just pass out straight away to space, whereas 34% get absorbed by atmosphere. That means, I should not use the word actually percent over here, but as we are saying 51%, consider that 51% only, then out of, or rather we can use the word unit. So suppose 35 units are reflected back, 14 units are absorbed, so total 49 units are absorbed. Then 51 units are reach at Earth surface, whereas out of that 51, the 17 units get absorbed by 17 units gets reflected back to the space, whereas 34 units get absorbed by atmosphere. So what is the total here again? 51 unit, that is the total that we are giving split. Now out of that 34 is, we have to add over here, because atmosphere is absorbing 14% and from insulation, and 34% from radiated by Earth. So total atmosphere is receiving 14 plus 34. So that gives total of 48. Now 48 units are reflected back in the space by atmosphere. Reflected back by atmosphere in the space. So here we are getting 48 units get reflected back from atmosphere. Now 35 units are reflected back by atmosphere, whereas the 17 units get radiated by Earth surface, that is also going in space. So the 52 units are given by space. Net total 48 plus 52, you are getting 100. So if 100 units are incoming, then 100 units are outgoing. And this way, the heat budget is called, because we are balancing out, say, whatever the radiations coming out, that means insulation, that is sent back to space. So this is basic idea, that whatever the sun is giving us energy, that energy is practically